So, mic check, part two, mic check. Hopefully this lapel mic works, Rode lapel mic. And yeah, it seems like we got enough tourists here to keep it nice and slow so I can chat about what I did today. And what I did was replace the carburetor on the DRZ. Well, I didn't actually replace it, but I took it out. I had a Chinese knockoff of the Mikuni, which is OEM from Suzuki. And to be honest, I gotta say that the quality of the Chinese carburetor was lacking. And so a weeks ago I put in the new carburetor because the bike was having idle issues, and put in the new carb, wouldn't start, tested everything, wouldn't start. And so I cleaned the other carb, put it back in, and it still had a couple of idle issues, specifically slow to idle, from fast idle to low idle. And so according to the YouTube gods, the online gods, the solution was to completely retract the idle adjustment. But really, that was a, you know, the idle adjustment is there for a reason. It's not to deaden the function of the carburetor. And so I wanted to actually get at the root of the problem, which I believe was the diaphragm. So I took out the old carburetor, cleaned it, and swapped out a jet and the diaphragm. It's pretty spectacular. And when I went to start the bike, it ran. I ran it for the day, and then we got some heavy rain the next day, and the bike wouldn't start at all. No go. And so I took the carburetor out again. By the way, a ratchet strap is a great tool for getting the carburetor back in. Strap it to the frame of the panniers and cinch it down, and it holds the rear air boot, and you can squeeze the carburetor back in quite nicely. But that's by the by. And so I got the carburetor part. I took out the pieces from the Chinese carburetor, put back the original, and but what I did do is replace the diaphragm for the main needle, the main jet, and took what I could off of the old one, because the old carburetor was pretty beat up. And so the idle adjustment clasp that holds it in place was not functioning, and there were a number of other issues. I also took the fuel lines off, replaced those, And the end result is that the bike runs like a top. And I think it's because the diaphragm is actually, you know, it's got some more flexibility. I also made sure that the main jet had free movement. And I also set the air mixture back to the correct adjustment out. Now, the one mistake that I did do is I put an inline filter between the tank and the carb, and that caused it to struggle just to get some fuel. And so I actually had to remove the inline filter from the carburetor. And so once I did that and I adjusted the air screw back down to lean. Oh, and I did check the spark. The spark plug was had residue on it, black, and so, well, not black, but it was oily. So it's running, it was running rich. And so it's been a fine tuning between having it backfiring and running rich. And you can hear it now. Needs a new muffler, but it actually runs amazing. So I'll just pull over here and we'll take a little look here at Trial Island. Anyways, back to the bike. So you can see I took the Chinese idle adjustment, I took the drain plug, I took the screws, and whatever else I could. And the bonus being that it starts right off the bat. The real test will be tomorrow morning. But the idle's good. RPM's good at idle. There's no high idle. Apart from the noise from the muffler, it's all good. Bit of a backfire. Bit of a backfire, which means that the air idle adjustment needs to come out just a hair to allow for a, you hear that? Backfiring. That's what we want to avoid. The other thing that needs to be adjusted is the float, right? Because if you have the float not allowing enough fuel, then it's going to cause a lean, poor performance. Suzuki tunes these bikes to be lean for emission control from the factory, and so if the carburetor hasn't been adjusted, then you need to go in and actually take the time and adjust the float. And adjusting the float is easy. You hold it on an angle until the float and the needle just are touching. It's got some good pickup. Yeehaw! Oh, this is quite pretty. Safety thing too, because when you're trying to avoid backfiring because your throttle's misadjusted, throttling down, it actually prohibits you from running the bike properly, which you need to do. You gotta rely on that return throttle instead of using the brake. Shifts. This thing sounds clean. Nice and clean. I think I actually will leave it just running a bit lean, the backfire, just to clean that stuff out. Also, the fuel mileage went to shit when it went rich. Is this audio coming through? Who knows? That's a mystery.
Carry me, I want to fly like an eagle, till I'm free, right through. slipping, slipping, slipping.